As hashtag Syria under attack began trending, Maryam al-Mansouri and news of her involvement in the airstrikes against ISIS in Syria became a contentious issue on Twitter. And with that, a gender-based conversation began around the question, is there a place for women on the battlefield? Shabib, a Kuwaiti on Twitter, doesn't seem to think so. He commented on Twitter saying, Maryam al-Mansouri has led attacks on Syrian civilians and has killed hundreds of innocent people. He says, have they run out of men?
I object to having any women take part in armed combat. It is known that the battlefields are for men only and no place for a woman. A woman's role in conflict is confined to treating the wounded, and they have excelled in that.
But Jordanian human rights activist Nama Habajna tweeted in support of having women out there defending their countries against terrorism. In a tweet, she says that Maryam al-Mansouri is a great example of an Arab woman who can defend herself and her country.
I think sitting in home and waiting until ISIS came to our homes and take us like slaves, slavery, and sell us in the stores, I think it will not be the hero. The hero is the most thing is to go outside and fight and protect yourself. She's a great woman for myself.
Major Maryam al-Mansouri is who did this. I hope that hurt extra bad from you, because in some Arab countries, women can't even drive. Her nickname, per Jennifer Griffin, Lady Liberty.
There you go.
But it's not just Arab men on social media who have made inflammatory comments around this woman's role in this conflict.
Problem is, after she bombed it, she couldn't park it.
America's largest news network, Fox, provoked a Twitter storm with its comments on this issue.
Would that be considered boobs on the ground or no?
Some took the opportunity to point out the disparities between what women can do in the United Arab Emirates and can't do in its neighboring Saudi Arabia.